In today's exploration of Revelations, we will be reading from chapters 4 and 5. The world today has become fascinated by the afterlife, ghosts, spirits, angels, and demons. There are many TV shows on now that seek information of the paranormal. They are trying to reach out to those that have passed, seeking the unexplained, curious of good and evil, what lies beyond this life. The Bible only records two people to have seen heaven as they lived on the earth. The first was the Apostle Paul, who wrote about being transported to the third heaven, the abode of God, in 2 Corinthians 12. However, he was forbidden to speak of what he saw there. The other is the Apostle John, who wrote the book we are currently studying, and God allowed him to give a detailed description of the things he saw. The Bible refers to heaven over 500 times, yet John's description in these two chapters is the most complete description given. John gives us a glimpse of eternity in the second vision here in Revelations. After these things I looked, and behold, a door standing open in heaven, and the first voice which I heard was like a trumpet speaking with me, saying, "Come up here, and I will show you things which must take place after this." Immediately I was in the Spirit, and behold, a throne set in heaven, and one sat on the throne. And he who sat there was like jasper, and a sardis stone in appearance. And there was a rainbow around the throne, in appearance like an emerald. Around the throne were 24 thrones, and on those thrones I saw 24 elders sitting, clothed in white robes, and they had crowns of gold on their head. And from the throne proceeded lightning, thunderings, and voices. Seven lamps of fire were burning before the throne, which are the seven spirits of God. Before the throne there was a sea of glass, like crystal. And in the midst of the throne and around the throne were four living creatures full of eyes in front and back. The first living creature was like a lion, the second living creature like a calf. The third living creature had a face like a man, and the fourth living creature was like a flying eagle. The four living creatures, each having six wings, were full of eyes around and within, and they do not rest day or night, saying, "Holy, holy, holy, Lord God Almighty, who was and is to come." Whenever the living creatures give glory and honor and thanks to him who sits on the throne, who lives forever and ever, the 24 elders fall down before him who sits on the throne and worship him who lives forever and ever, and cast their crowns before the throne, saying, "You are worthy, O Lord, to receive glory and honor and power, for you created all things, and by your will they exist and were created." Now, before we continue into chapter 5, let's take a moment and break apart some key things in this chapter. The elders in this church are believed to be the redeemed. Which redeemed? They are a representation of the redeemed church. They worship the Lord and sing a song of redemption. The four living creatures are the cherubim, angels of God. They are also referred to in Ezekiel chapter 4. Their images symbolize strength and power, humble service, rational thinking, swiftness to fulfill their service. As John enters and sees the throne, it's interesting the jewels that he chooses to describe it with. In verse 3, he describes the one who sat on there as jasper, which could be a reference to a diamond, clear, brilliant, and refracts all the colors of the spectrum. I can picture it as almost being blinding. Sardis is a fiery red ruby stone. Emerald has a cool green hue. John describes it like a rainbow surrounding the throne, which symbolizes God's faithfulness, his promise, his word. He set a rainbow in the sky to seal the covenant with Noah. I can imagine that John is in total awe of the sight, and here he is trying to describe the wonders he sees for his readers in the best words and pictures he can present. I mean, human words have limitations. They cannot describe what he sees. He is limited in the descriptions he can give us. It's like you witness an amazing sunset in the mountains overlooking an ocean. Even if you take a picture to share, it still does not capture the moment and the awesomeness of nature in what you're seeing at that time. Even if you show that to your friends and try to describe it to them, they're like, "Yep, it's a sunset." Pictures and words cannot express the beauty and awesomeness. It limits us, just as it limits John in his descriptions and how he can present what he is seeing to us. Now let's continue on with chapter 5. And I saw in the right hand of him who sat on the throne a scroll written inside and on the back, sealed with seven seals. Then I saw a strong angel proclaiming with a loud voice, "Who is worthy to open the scrolls and to loose its seals?" And no one in heaven or on earth or under the earth was able to open the scroll or to look at it. So I wept much, because no one was found worthy to open and read the scroll or to look at it. But one of the elders said to me, "Do not weep. Behold, the Lamb of the tribe of Judah, the root of David, has prevailed to open the scroll and to loose its seven seals." And I looked, and behold, in the midst of the throne and the four living creatures, and in the midst of the elders, stood a lamb, as though it had been slain, having seven horns and seven eyes, which are the seven spirits of God sent out into all of the earth. Then he came and took the scroll out of the right hand of him who sat on the throne. Now when he had taken the scroll, the four living creatures and the 24 elders fell down before the lamb, each having a harp and golden bowl full of incense, which are the prayers of the saints. And they sang a new song, saying, "You are worthy to take the scroll and to open its seals, for you were slain and have been redeemed, and have redeemed us to God by your blood out of every tribe and tongue and people and nation, and have made us kings and priests to our God, and shall reign on the earth." Then I looked, and I heard the voice of many angels around the throne and living creatures and the elders, and the number of them was 10,000 times 10,000 and thousands of thousands, saying with a loud voice, "Worthy is the Lamb who was slain to receive power and riches and wisdom and strength and honor and glory and blessing. And every creature which is in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and such as are in the sea and all that are in them, I heard saying, blessed and honor and glory to the power to be to him who sits on the throne and to the Lamb forever and ever." And the four living creatures said, "Amen." And 24 elders fell down and worshiped him who lives forever and ever. As we read through these two chapters in Revelations, did you notice how many times the word throne was there? It was there 18 times, and 15 of these refer to the throne of God. The throne symbolizes sovereign rule and authority. One of the main subjects and focuses here in chapter 5 is the scroll. The way the scroll is described would be typical of how ancient contracts would have been written. These could have been deeds, rental agreements, leases, wills, these types of things. With these scrolls, the inside would contain the details, while the outside or back of the document would be a summary of what was on the inside. John MacArthur states that this scroll was almost certainly a deed, the title deed to the earth. This scroll was sealed with seven different seals. Roman sealed their wills seven times on the edge at each roll. This helped to prevent unauthorized entry into their wills. Hebrew title deeds of this time required a minimum of three seals, with more important transactions requiring more witnesses and more seals. Did you notice the description of Jesus here? He is described as the Lamb who was slain, having seven horns and seven eyes. It is an interesting description to me, because a lamb would be timid and easy to slay. However, he is said to have seven horns, which symbolizes power. In the animal kingdom, horns were used in battle to inflict wounds in combat. And here it is said the lamb had seven horns. With seven being the perfect number, it's easy to assume that Jesus is described as having perfect or complete power over everything. There's a lot of symbolism and references to things here on earth. The harp, which was used to sing songs of God's people, bowls full of incense, which they had in the tabernacle, prayers of the saints, and the new song, a reference to the Old Testament and the new song that flows from a heart that has experienced God's redemption. It's amazing to me the amount of time we could spend just reading through each scripture and analyzing each verse, diving deep into all the meanings that are there. I hope you're studying more on your own during the week, and I look forward to next week where we read and dive into the opening of the seven seals. I pray you have a blessed week, and see you next week.